Hello! Welcome to Hangar YouTube channel. Today we will be looking into the air data inertial reference system of Airbus A320 aircraft. The air data inertial reference unit, ADIRU, comprises of an air data reference, ADR, system and an inertial reference, IR, system. Both these systems are included in a single unit. There are three ADIRUs in Airbus A320. ADIRU 1 is dedicated to captain's instruments, ADIRU 2 is dedicated to first officer instruments, and ADIRU 3 is dedicated to standby instruments. ADIRUs will also provide data to FMGCs. The ADIRU uses inputs from external sensors such as angle of attack sensors, total air temperature sensors, and air data modules. The ADIRUs are interfaced with the air data inertial reference system mode selector unit. First, we will look at air data module. There are 8 ADMs in Airbus A320 ADIRS system. The ADM has a microcomputer which processes an ARINC signal according to the discrete inputs and to the digitized pressure. The ADM inputs are one pressure input and several discrete inputs. The ADMs are identical and fully interchangeable. The discrete inputs determine the ADM location and the type of pressure data, pitot or static, provided to the ADR. The ADM output is an ARINC bus, which gives digital pressure information, type of pressure, ADM identification, and byte status to the ADIRU. Now we'll look at ADM inputs and outputs. Number 1. Pitot probes. Three pitot probes provide total pressure to three air data modules, which convert this pressure into digital format, ARINC 429. ARINC words are then sent to the corresponding air data inertial reference unit. For an example, captain's pitot probe sends pressure signal to related ADM. The transducer inside ADM converts this pressure signal into an analog signal, and this analog signal is converted to a digital signal by an analog to digital converter. Then via the microcomputer inside the ADM, this digital signal gets converted to an ARINC output. ADM will identify the pressure source using the discrete signal. Power to operate the ADM comes from the related ADIRU, in this case ADIRU 1. Number 2. Static ports. Six static ports provide static pressure to five ADMs, which convert this pressure into digital format, ARINC 429. The two standby static ports provide an average pressure directly to the standby instruments and to ADR 3 through a single ADM. Next, we will look at other two sensors which supply information to ADIRU's ADR part. Those are the angle of attack sensor and total air temperature sensor. Angle of attack sensors give information to its corresponding ADIRU. For an example, the angle of attack probe 1 provides information to ADIRU 1. Total air temperature sensors. The three ADIRUs receive total air temperature information from two total air temperature sensors. Total air temperature sensor 1 will provide information to ADIRU 1 and 3. Total air temperature sensor 2 will provide information only to ADIRU 2. Next, we will look at the inertial reference part. IR part has an IR strapdown system which has gyros and accelerometers. In a strapdown inertial reference system, the gyros and the accelerometers are solidly attached to the aircraft structure. The strapdown laser gyros and accelerometers supply directly the accelerations and angular speeds. For each ADIRU, there are three laser gyros and three accelerometers. First, we'll look at the gyros. There are three ring laser gyros, one for each rotation axis. These give inertial rotation data and are composed of two opposite laser beams in a ring. At rest, the two beams get to the sensor with the same frequency. An aircraft rotation creates a difference of frequencies between the two beams. The frequency difference is measured by optical means, which will be an analog output. This analog output will be sent to an analog-to-digital converter. After computation, this output will provide rotation information. The next component in the IR system are the accelerometers. There are three accelerometers, one for each axis. They provide linear accelerations. The acceleration signal is sent to an analog-to-digital converter. The digitized signal is then sent to a processor, which uses this signal to compute the velocity and the position. IR computation will be done by each ADIRU based on its three laser gyros and the three accelerometer signals to provide IR data to users. So this is a simple introduction to the ADIRU system of Airbus A320. So if you like the content, please subscribe to our channel. You can also join our Facebook page from the link in the description. Please do click the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.